If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Greetings, everyone! Melkadrine here, and I'm here to show you Helen's Mysterious Castle. This game, made using a RPG Maker game. This is an interesting one because I've never heard of this sort of RPG Maker until I played this. It's called RPG School 2000, which is not to be confused with RPG Maker 2000. However, the team that made this, the RPG Maker 2000, is Enterbrain, which is pretty much the same team that made RPG Maker. So basically they're the same thing. They're made from the same developer. That's what I'm trying to say. However, there's a few differences between School and Maker. For example, if you were to play this game with the English regional settings, you're going to see some font issues. Basically, it'll look kind of weird. If you play this under the Japanese regional settings, as you see right here, it looks just fine. That's the only major visual problem with this game. Everything else is just fine. As you can see, overworld, characters, animation, very well made animations for that matter. You mustn't go near the northern ruins. They're dangerous. Let's go near the northern ruins and see what's up there. Oh, there's a slime. Well, let's see. Do I have any equipment? Nope. There isn't even a menu. So let's see what we can find around the house. A longbow. Well, we can use that. We can open up the menu with escape and dash with shift. Woo, I'm dashing. I'm running around the whole place. Now, breaking pots is actually a good thing in this game. Yes, we find health boosters, which boost our health. Also check out the closets. However, we cannot check out the bookshelf. Yes, the main character, who is called Helen, cannot read books. Is unable to read. At this point, anyways. Later on in the game, Helen will be able to read, but right now she can't. Anyways, with longbow in hand, let's fight the slime. As you can see, the combat is visually completely different from a RPG Maker game that you would normally see. As you can see, the weapon that we have right now is the longbow. And on the bottom you can see its effect, the defense, and the wait time. Now in detail, the effect is the effect of ability for the weapon, or shield. Well, actually not for shield, because shields are under the defense. For example, this longbow deals 10 damage, and its wait time, which is basically let's just say that's how long it has to take for it to activate. For example, it takes 5 rounds in order for that longbow attack to activate and to deal damage to this slime here. And we win! We get experience, and experience is actually used for leveling up weapons. For example, I used 1 XP to level up my longbow. Now it deals 1 extra damage. Certain weapons have certain level up aspects. Some increase the damage, some increase the defense, some affect the amount of time it takes in order for it to activate. Basically shortens. A wooden shield. As you can see, that one says defense on it, which means that when you activate this right off the bat, she will be defending. See? Takes no damage throughout that entire wait period. Now, the damage is calculated by effect minus defense. For example, my wooden shield has 18 defense, and that slime's body blow has 14 damage, which means 14 minus 18 is less than 0, so it deals 0 damage. However, for my longbow, 14 minus 2 equals 12 damage. And you don't get a game over screen in this game. If you die, you don't exactly get a game over, so you can basically continue as many times as you want. Haha, I defeat the pot.
I'm a combat expert. You shall think of me as your teacher.
Huh?
Hmm? No, your master. Think of me as your master. That's cooler. I live here, teaching those I deem worthy how to defeat monsters. If you come across a new type of enemy, come talk to me. I'll give you a hint on how to defeat them.
Yes, some monsters are actually a little more clever because, well, they change up their patterns depending on what attack you're using. Not only that, but also on... well, on whether you're defending or whether you're attacking and how long it takes in order for that attack to fire off. So in a way, sometimes you're going to be wanting to use fast weaponry, and sometimes you want to use powerful weaponry in order to defeat some of these enemies, like that skeleton. We got a health booster. Let's see. Actually, the secret is actually down here. You can see the raised tile right here. Bam! Secret passage. Now, the good thing is that you can act... well, in order... basically, combat, it's your turn and then their turn. So... for, like, right now, their weight is at zero, but their turn does not start until we act. See? My turn, their turn. My turn, their turn. As you can see, I went with my longbow a little too early, and I got hurt because of it. Which is not a problem, since we can go back to that healing spring and heal ourselves. A longsword. A longsword is a little more stronger than a longbow. It takes a little... well, swords take a little more time before they work, before they activate. But they do have that added benefit of defense. Yes, swords allow you to defend yourself. They're a middle-of-the-road weaponry. They're effective... and yet, sometimes, you're better off using your longbow. I've played this game, and the longbow is pretty much the main weapon that I would... well, that I've used throughout the entire game. And mainly because the damage is there, it is also very quick to activate, 5 rounds. Which means you can actually deal a lot of damage in a short amount of time. Now let's fight this skeleton. As you can see, his longsword basically has a lot of defense on it. So let's use our longsword to combat it. Well, actually, that's not a good idea. Let's just use our bow because, hey, our longbow is a little stronger than that, well, than our longsword. And we haven't leveled up our longsword. Bam! Now we have to continue onward or, well, that skeleton will respawn. Another skeleton!
Take the power of longbow into mine hand and defeat yon skeleton.
Once you get the hang of it, it becomes straightforward on how to actually, well, do a battle with these enemies. The only tricky part is trying to figure out how to bait the enemy into, well, using the move you want them to use so you can beat them quickly. And we got a Tome of Thunder. As you can see, it has defense piercing, which means that these tomes, they take a while for the effect to activate, but it punches through all defense. These are the weapons that you will basically use if an enemy is blocking or has a lot of defense on their attacks. Ah, a mummy! Are you my mummy? I should have went with the tome. Oh well. Pull up my shield. Ooh. Well, that's not good. Alright, let's try and... beat this mummy quickly. Oh dang, it didn't deliberate. Well, I'm done for. And as you can see, we got defeated. And that mummy stole our thunder. Yes. Not all monsters steal equipment, but that mummy right there, he seems personally attached to that thunder spell. Good morning, Helen. I made you a steak. Eating the steak boosts our max HP. And we're back at the top. There are certain places where we will return to, like this house here, whenever we get defeated. And there are times when we will get a steak to eat. Delicious steak. Anyways, Helen's Mysterious Castle, it is a... well, in my opinion, it's a fun game. I really like it. I've had a lot of fun with this game, and yet I have not collected all the weapons in this game. I have not. And yet, I still like this. And for the price it is, I believe it was less than $10. I'm not sure of the exact price, but I know it's less than $10. And this isn't... well, you can't buy this on Steam. I got this game from Playism, I believe. Yes, Playism. I'll have the link to this game in the description if you guys are interested in this game. Anyways, Helen's Mysterious Castle, very nice game, and before we end, I'll show you how to save. Bam! You're saved. You can save anywhere you want to. You can save anywhere in this entire game. You want to save near the final boss? Fine, perfect. Go right ahead. You can save wherever you want, because the game does not prevent you from saving anywhere. Anyways, Helen's Mysterious Castle, very good game. I recommend you guys check it out. I'll have the link to the game in the description. So until next time, this is Malkadrian, and this has been Helen's Mysterious Castle. I'll see you guys next time.